Pay me, pay me, pay me my silver now. Pay me or go to jail. Pay me my silver now.
Good morning, Big Square Roadrunner.com with your morning horn of the seas, your sip of chaga coffee. All right, second night sleeping in the off-road RV. Not bad. Amy slept well last night. I woke up at like, we went to bed early, like at 9. I hate going to bed at 9 because I know I'm going to wake up in the middle of the night, which I did, having my silver dreams. I dreamt that silver broke through $25. It was a glorious day. That's how sad the silver market is right now. It looked like a little, you know, manipulative play going on this morning. If you check out the charts, silver was about to break through $23 and then got slammed down. The slams just aren't exciting anymore. We missed the $50 to $20 slams. You should know by now that silver is a rigged market. It has been a rigged market for probably 170 years of price suppression. But we'll just say since the 1970s, when we went off the gold standard and they implemented the current version of the CFTC. The CFTC, oh my God, what a pathetic institution. Here are your current commissioners. Rostin Benham, Don DeBerry Stump, the Stumpster, and then Dan Berkovitz, who we held out hope for Dan. He was going to uphold the law, so the banksters decided to get rid of him. So he left. He resigned. I did find out where he's going. Departing CFTC commissioner to join the SEC. Who could have predicted this? I told you. He was going to go where Gary Gensler goes. Gary Gensler's the new head of the SEC. Probably the only guy with half a brain in the entire regulatory world. He's trying an impossible task. The task he's trying to get done is to regulate a corrupt market. Hopefully he's not just looking to cover up. So far that's what he has done. You can regulate so far, but when you run into corruption that might destroy the system, that's when he stops regulating. Gary Gensler was the regulator at the CFTC when they're rigging the gold and silver markets that JP Morgan just got busted for. I get what Gary's trying to do, but it is impossible to regulate a rigged market that has to be rigged for the system to stay in place. So, I don't know. Dan Berkovitz going over to work for Gary Gensler. I said that's probably what will happen. I think they're going to shut down the CFTC and put everything under the SEC after, you know, the market chaos. So we'll see. Dan Berkovitz has signed on to become the general counsel at the Securities and Exchange Commission less than 3 weeks since announcing his intention to step down as commissioner at the CFTC. He was the general counsel of the CFTC as well. Do I think it's good or bad? I don't know. You know, what they're trying to do is introduce regulation to a criminal and corrupt system. Check this out. Gary Gensler to Wall Street. Prepare for the everything crackdown. If you crack down on everything, you will destroy the system. We're talking about a $3 quadrillion derivative market you're going to have to regulate. Good luck with that, Gary, in keeping the system. Everybody's going to hate you, but it's not your fault. You're trying to introduce rules and regulations and honesty into a system that's so corrupt, so beyond repair. I don't know what's going to happen. Regardless of what thinks of SEC Chairman Gensler, he certainly seems to be bringing more to the table in terms of regulations than his predecessor, Jay Clayton. In fact, Gensler is readying an everything crackdown, according to Bloomberg. Gensler has already proposed 48 separate changes for his staff to consider implementing, the report says, calling it one of the most ambitious agency agendas in the SEC's 87-year history. At the same time, he's kept an aggressive stance on ongoing enforcement actions. Gensler even said in a recent interview that he thinks about a famous Martin Luther King Jr. speech about the fierce urgency of now. All you guys who are invested in XRP, don't forget what Gary Gensler said when he was teaching cryptocurrencies at MIT. And if you haven't seen the speech, you can get them all online. All his classes are online. Great classes on cryptocurrencies. He absolutely understands it. But he flat out, he said it. XRP is a security. Of course it's a security. But there's so many of them that are obvious securities. EOS is one. Block One should have been, all those people should have been in jail a long time ago. But what he said after he said that XRP is obviously a security, he said, but that will be decided by the courts. I think this was even before XRP was getting slammed down by the courts. So we will see. I think they're gonna determine that XRP was a security, and that opens everything up for Gary Gensler, and he's in the right place to put his hammer down against cryptos. I don't know. In the long run, the good cryptos will be the ones left standing, and that's where I am invested, along with the 170-year price-suppressed silver. You know, crypto people are so used to their special cryptos going crazy. Why would you invest in silver? It doesn't go up. They will just be blown away by the going up part of silver very soon. We're not talking, you know, 10x, 20x, 30x, 50x, 100x. We're talking 1-to-1 gold. 1,000x. That's what happens when you suppress the price of one of the most essential commodities, if not the essential commodity on the planet, silver. In the electronic age, our high-tech future, you cannot survive without silver. People keep asking me, well, Bix, they're going to invent a way to manufacture silver from atoms. Yeah, they will. 40, 50, 100, 200, 300 years from now. Right now, no. Not in your lifetime, not in your kids' lifetime. That they are not going to be able to make silver from thin air. You know, obviously, it's been tried for thousands of years. Silver from thin air in the near future. It's just not going to happen. And they can't hold the price of silver down for the next, you know, 100, 200 years. You might think they could, but because they have for 170 years, but they aren't going to. Sorry. The jig is up, as they say. So you are in silver, not gold necessarily. Gold will double or triple, but silver's going to go up 100, 1,000%. Not 1,000%, 1,000x. 1,000 times what it is now. Yes, silver will be priced when gold goes to $20,000 an ounce. After the gold suppression ends, silver will be right next to it at $20,000 an ounce. Do that math and figure out if you want to own cryptos or silver during this transition. I say both. 50-50. I like to try to keep my ratio at 50-50. It's going to be hard buying so many cryptos with all those silver gains, though. But it's good. It's a good thing. It's a good problem to have. Anyway, so yes, silver's being rigged today. Interesting, odd, obvious day. And these three people, Rossen Benham, Don DeBerry Stump, and Dan Berkovitz, hey, you're still on the commission until the 15th. So you got 2 more days. You can still pull the trigger, but you haven't. So you probably won't. So we'll be down to 2 out of 5 commissioners. I think they're going to shut down the CFTC and just roll it into the SEC. They don't do anything anyway. And they got a $120 million annual budget. So keep an eye out for that. Because the Biden administration has added nobody. Nobody. They keep falling off. There's going to be 0 commissioners. What could be going on at the Biden administration? It's ridiculous. We do have a meeting. We have a meeting on the 25th of the Global Markets Advisory Committee. This is who runs the CFTC. The CFTC isn't run by these 5 commissioners. They don't do anything. They are told what to do. Who are they told by? There's I think 6 different committees. Look at these committees. This is just one of them. This is called the, where is it here? Global Markets Advisory Committee. So Don Stump is the sponsor. Do you want to know who Don Stump is told what to do by? Look at the members of this committee. Nomura Securities, Standard Bank, Morgan Stanley, RBC. Look at all these people involved in the rigging of markets. Angie Camara, Chris Allen, Ted Backer, Ashley Belch, Sean Bernardo of ICAP, Darcy Bradbury of D.E. Shaw, Maria Chody of Credit Suisse, Joseph Kawinski, Better Markets, Jim Colby, Coal Derivatives, Jerry Coren. Look at all these companies and individuals, and then there's subcommittees. Look at these subcommittees. It is insane how many people are up. No, there's BlackRock and Virtu Financial, the lovely Virtu Financial, the market rigging coordinator on SLV, Virtu Financial. I have a discussion and interview with our friends over at Wall Street Bets YouTube channel about silver. We're going to record it Friday, but they usually don't release it till like the next week. So we're going to be talking about silver market rigging. It's so funny. We'll be talking about all the stuff I talk about every day, but to a larger audience. They have a lot of people listening to them now, which is great. The more people who know that the silver market is rigged, the more people will understand that why it's so important to get your hands on physical, in your own possession only. Contact Andy Scheckman at Miles Franklin. He'll get you, say you're from Roto-Rooter, he'll get you the best price. Andy, A-N-D-Y at MilesFranklin.com, MilesFranklin.com. Do not wait. You can get silver under $25, under $30. Depends on what kind of silver you want to get. I highly suggest the pre-65 coinage. That's my favorite. Silver Eagles as well. Remember, those are U.S. Mint coinage. That means they are actual money of the United States of America. They're not Federal Reserve notes. And they're physical. They're in your own possession. They're harder to counterfeit or to fake. You can fake silver bars. And you can get busted for fraud. If you fake U.S. Silver Eagles or pre-65 coinage, you get busted for counterfeiting, which is huge, huge penalties compared to just fraud. Keep that in mind. People will trust in the United States. They'll trust that money that says the U.S. Mint. I don't know why. The Mint's been in on the rig. You know, the U.S. Mint is probably the largest hedger of metal, even when they run out. They don't close out their hedges. It's just ridiculous. Your government is fighting against you. Anyway, I talked yesterday about the Theta Fuel. People are saying, Bix, which would you invest in, Theta or Theta Fuel? Theta's had a good run compared to Theta Fuel. Theta Fuel, if you stake it, you make a hell of a lot more Theta Fuel than staking the same amount of Theta, dollar-wise. So right now, at the 20-to-1 ratio, I'm saying buy Theta Fuel and stake Theta Fuel. Now, don't take out your Theta if it's already staked because you're going to get T-Drop, the newest crypto from the Theta team. T-Drop comes out in February. So if you're staking now, and if you've been staking for the last few months, keep staking until the T-Drop comes out. I don't know if it's all at once or it's accrued over time. Just sit and hodl. Just stake and hodl. But if you're working with new money, switching some Bitcoin to T-Fuel or Theta, definitely go T-Fuel and then stake your T-Fuel so you can earn more T-Fuel. All right? Over the last 7 days, you can see that T-Fuel has performed twice as good as Theta. But Theta was running up anyway. So I do see, I think this ratio will start to squeeze in closer to 5-to-1, its original. I don't think it'll get all the way to 5-to-1, but I think it'll get under 10, which is double what you can make T-Fuel right now. That's my take. But, you know, the bad guys could hear this and, you know, jack the price of Theta or T-Fuel. It's all rigged. Remember that as well. And make sure that it's in your own possession. That's the only people who are going to survive the crypto crash. People with good cryptos in your own possession. If you ICO'd, if you own any cryptos that ICO'd, you're in trouble with Gary Gensler. A lot of those cryptos will not survive if they ICO. Theta never ICO'd. They're very careful about that. So just keep that in mind. And go to roadtoruda.com for the latest action. Hit subscribe today. And we are now giving away, there it is, 50 T-Fuel loaded on a paper wallet mailed to your front door with every private road subscription. So definitely go check that out. That amount will change as T-Fuel rises. So just keep that in mind. But right now we're giving out 50 T-Fuel loaded on a paper wallet for every private road subscription and renewal. This is Big Square, roadrunner.com. I'll talk to you later.
All right, it's time to have a little fun with our friends on the comics. This song goes out to that big old gigantic naked short out there. You know who you are. It's kind of lonely at the top, ain't it? I thought I heard the people say, pay me my silver now. Tomorrow's another trading day. But pay me my silver now. Watching the COMEX prices rise. Pay me my silver now. JP Morgan naked shows the highs. Pay me my silver now. Pay me, pay me, pay me my silver now. Pay me or go to jail. Pay me my silver now. CFTC, you better shut it down. Pay me my silver now. There's people rising up in every town. Pay me my silver now. The Gata boys are in the know. Pay me my silver now. Tinfoil hats at the silver show. Pay me my silver now. Pay me, pay me, pay me my silver now. Pay me or go to jail. Pay me my silver now. Butler nails you every time you try. Pay me my silver now. The BPS shows how much you like. Pay me my silver now. The game is done when the silver's gone. Pay me my silver now. COMEX metal in the warehouse, none. Pay me my silver now. Pay me, pay me, pay me my silver now. Pay me or go to jail. Pay me my silver now. The banking boys melt that witch. Pay me my silver now. Deliver those bars and melt that bitch. Pay me my silver now. Pay me, pay me, pay me my silver now. Pay me or go to jail. Pay me my silver now. So now is the time. Free our land. Pay me my silver now. Silver in my pocket, paper in the can. Pay me my silver now. Pay me, pay me, pay me my silver now. Pay me or go to jail. Pay me my silver now. Pay me, pay me, pay me my silver now. Pay me or go to jail. Pay me my silver now.